Well, folks, it appears that I have a little story for you, and, in true Tall Bike Tommy community TV fashion, I've got no notes, no script. I'm just going to tell you what happened, because, you know, as Judge Judy always used to say, you know, if you're telling a lie, it's harder to remember everything, you know, and when you're telling the truth, you don't have to remember anything. So that's the way I operate. Judge Judy taught me a lot. Let's get down to business here. Let's set the scene for you here. It's a beautiful, beautiful moonlight. It's a Thursday, you know. They're setting up for Rib Fest downtown. It was a couple weeks back. Downtown, sort of having a little walk around and go out on Finley Bridge there because the bridge is shut down to car traffic. You know, it gets just, you could walk across the bridge and folks tend to enjoy that, especially when it's a nice night out and the moon is just beautiful. Get out to the middle of Finley Bridge, talking with a few folks, and I noticed Lester Landry, you know, local man accused of kidnapping. Got the charges coming up there. Looks like trials October 13th, my birthday. Ha! That's funny. Weird coincidences, right? Anyways, so I'm standing on the bridge, moonlight beautiful, a couple folks on the bridge. You know, we're having a chat. I noticed Lester Landry there. You know, but I kind of just had ignored that he had been, you know, going up and down the bridge with his dog on his wheelchair, just sort of scooting back and forth. And then he noticed me. I think it was because I had my community TV jacket on. I got a nice jacket my mom got me years ago, and I got the Calm TV logo silk screened onto the back of it. And it's just lasted a long time. The silk screening looks beautiful. The jacket's still beautiful. The thing is impermeable. It's one of my favorite jackets. But, you know, it's only really good for like fall time. You know, it's got that thinsulate inner lining and then sort of like a fall jacket type, you know, exterior. Anyhow, love the jacket. Thanks, Mom. I think that Lester Landry saw the back of the jacket with the community TV logo on it because he came scooting up next to me on that scooter real close and he mumbled and he kind of like, I don't know, cursed me out. You know, friggin' community TV don't know what the heck going on, blatant this and that. And I was just surprised. Wow, interesting. He got real close there. That was weird. Anyways, and then he starts scooting away and he says something to the effect of like F you, you effing S-H-I-T head, or I don't know. He said he dropped a bunch of foul words, and it was just not a very nice thing to yell on Finley Bridge in the beautiful moonlight. So, you know, the people that were like there that were I was chatting with on the bridge were kind of like, what the hell? I'm looking at this guy, you know, scooting away on a scooter, yelling obscenities at me. And I said, I'm not surprised that you would be a coward. And he reacted to the word coward, let me tell you. He stopped in his tracks. Lester Landry swung his head around to look at me. And he just puts the wheelchair into reverse. 29th gear, he hammered down the full force of the wheelchair right into me and then rolls right up over my right foot with the wheelchair. Then he turns to me and starts throwing bows, like straight up, just swinging his arms up towards me. I was shocked. I was laughing. I was curious about the absurdity of life. How do I find myself in a situation where Lester Landry is attacking me on Finley Bridge under the beautiful moonlight? Ruined the mood, really. Hurt my toe, even. The punches didn't, like, land in the face area. I remember guarding myself to some degree. Also, I believe there was disgust. I believe disgust was also one of the feelings and emotions that I felt. I was scared only to the extent that when insanity gets so close to you, it can be very scary. I mean, the physical attributes of this man throwing punches was, as I said, something kind of laughable. But, you know, when it comes down to it, I don't know what kind of things he's willing to do. If he's willing to use the wheelchair as a weapon, I don't know what he's willing to do. So anyhow, whew. He scoots off after he loses his nerve. I mean, he threw maybe 6 or 8 punches, and none of them really landed with any type of extreme force, but the look on his face, I mean, he was incensed. Like, right when I said the word coward, and he turned around and got locked eyes with me and started going in reverse, dude, he was just I mean, what is the word for that? Just when you're so angry that steam comes out of your ears like a cartoon type of thing. Anyways, when the steam had cooled down and his kettle had finished cooking, and he threw these 8 old man disabled fat guy punches, they didn't hurt. It was more of the sort of disgust of the sort of closeness of his person to mine was quite palpable. I can almost smell remembering this incident. After his kettle cooled off and he lost his nerve, he came back to his senses. I think he realized that he was completely in the wrong and doing something very insane. And he scooted away with his dog and his scooter. You know, I turned back to the folks that are on the bridge and they're just like, what in the heck just happened? So I explained to them who Lester Landry is, the history of my coverage of his stories, and also the history of Lester Landry as known on the internet to people who look into true crime, you know, because he himself has claimed that he's been questioned in 3 separate homicides in Canada. So when we talk about that, I think it's very important to honor the victims. You know, this whole thing isn't always about the big bad guy. Sometimes it's about remembering those victims and finding justice for them. So the two that I want to focus on today are Irene Pearson, that's a historical homicide, and then one that's much more recent and was right here in Medicine Hat and in a building where Lester Landry happened to live. Lester Landry has on his YouTube channel the Crime Stoppers Call to Action video re-uploaded onto his YouTube channel, featuring the information about how Hazel Lloyd's homicide has not been solved. And she was murdered in an apartment building, which is currently less than 2 blocks from where Lester Landry is living. So that's sort of an interesting point. Don't know. Anyhow, the reason I'm making this video today, and all of this happened, you know, weeks ago, is because I didn't want to get in the way of any kind of police action that's currently happening there. You know, if there's a kidnapping charge going on, and, you know, I don't want to sort of make some video content that somehow, you know, hurts the police's efforts to investigate that. But, you know, after I reported this assault, they investigated that, and they ended up charging Lester Landry with an assault, and I was notified of that today. And so he will be in court on October 31st to answer to the charge of assaulting me on the bridge under the beautiful moonlight. We will see, I guess, what's going to happen there, because, you know, in most cases, you know, when you have one charge and then, you know, another charge, things start to pile up. It doesn't always look so good, and it becomes a little more difficult to make, you know, deals or to, you know, get sort of a lenient sentencing, you know. So it's quite possibly an issue at this point. Lester has been ordered to stay away from me, so he can't come around where I'm at, which is, I think, that's good for me. But, you know, I'll still be allowed to go to the court, of course, to report on the kidnapping charge. And, of course, I'll be allowed to go to, you know, whatever court case that is happening, because I'm an accredited journalist with the Alberta courts, and it's my job to report on what's going on down there. And I think this is a story of public interest big time. I cannot count how many times people have stopped me, just in the grocery store even, and say, hey, what's the word on Lester Landry? What do you think's going to happen? What's going on with all this? So it's definitely something that the public is interested in big time. I, you know, I get messages every week. I want to find out when the next court case is. What's going on next? So I imagine there might be members of the public just at the trial if that's something that is allowed. And normally it is, you know. So interesting stuff going on. Lester Landry's been charged with assaulting me, and my life is super weird, and my job is very awkward and strange. And please support community TV if you can. support@comtv.ca is where you can send an email. I don't think I'm going to end up needing any kind of lawyer, because, like, I'm the victim here, but, you know, like I said, things are weird and things get weirder all the time. There are other actions in law where Kelly and I need your help. There's a story that we've been trying to tell for months and months and months now, and this person who is the subject of the story is doing everything possible to make sure that we can't tell this story without threat of arrest, because they have, I guess, the chutzpah to go into a court and get an ex parte restraining order against a journalist so that they can stuff the story down the drain. But it'll come out. It'll come out, you know, and it'll be faster. It'll come out a lot faster with your help. So anybody who signs up for like the Trash Panda periodical that we're doing on the comtv.ca website, that helps. If you want to send an e-transfer, that's support@comtv.ca. SUPPORT at comtv.ca. That helps us out a lot. You know, or if you just want to like do, I don't know, you want to like buy us a coffee at some local coffee shop, or I don't know, whatever it is, if there's any way you can help out me and Kelly to survive and to thrive and to tell these stories, you know, we would love to have your help and your protection. Because, I mean, obviously, you tell the story the right way, you get under the skin of some person who's accused of something terrible, and they start coming after you. I mean, damn. Not the first time I've had somebody come after me because I knew too much. But this Lester guy, oof, gives me the hibby-jibbies. He's back on the Give, Send, Go. I saw Give, Send, Go that he had started 3 days ago. You know, so it's just every fundraising effort website that he can get a hold of, he's on there to try and raise some funds. And I mean, at this point, I would probably start to wonder where those funds were going. You know, I mean, is this lawyer costing you anything? Because I know they cost me, you know. I could use about $7,000 right now so that all of the lawyers that I know would be hard at work for something that's important to you. but that's beside the point. You know, I'm done with the e-begging. I just wanted to remind you that it's possible to support us. And that Lester Landry assaulted me. And that on Thursday night on Finley Bridge, while they were setting up for that Ribfest, the moon was just beautiful.